As we have seen, Schrödinger's equation gives us the energy and wave function of a system. It is important to note that only very precise energies and wave functions satisfy Schrödinger's equation. Therefore, there will be limitations as to what can exist within an atom and what simply cannot. Taking the simplest atomic system possible, the hydrogen atom, one can come up with the entire set of exact wave functions that exist. These wave functions, also called orbitals when talking about individual electrons, are characterized by three quantum numbers, and the electron itself will be characterized by a fourth. The principal quantum number, n, is a positive whole number. This quantum number defines the size of the orbital. The smallest orbital is always the one with n equals 1, and the orbitals get progressively larger as n goes from 2 to 3 to 4 and beyond. The second quantum number is the azimuthal quantum number, L. It too must be a whole number, but its value is limited between 0 and n minus 1. So, if we are talking about an orbital with a principal quantum number of 1, L is limited to 0. If n equals 2, L is either 0 or 1. If n equals 3, L is either 0, 1, or 2, and so on for higher values of n. The azimuthal quantum number defines the shape of the orbital, as we often use letters to replace their numerical values. S orbitals have an L value of 0 and have a spherical shape. P orbitals have an L value of 1 and have this dumbbell-type shape. D orbitals have an L value of 2 and usually have a shape similar to two P orbitals perpendicular to one another. The relationship between the value of n and l explains why we have 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, and 3d orbitals, but we do not have 1p, 2d, or 3f orbitals, amongst many other combinations that simply cannot exist, as they are not solutions to Schrödinger's equation for the hydrogen atom. The third quantum number is the magnetic quantum number, m, and it is limited by the orbital's corresponding l value, as m can be any integer between negative l and positive l. So, for an s orbital where l equals 0, m can only equal 0. For a p orbital where l equals 1, m can be either negative 1, 0, or positive 1. Similarly, m can be either negative 2, negative 1, 0, positive 1, or positive 2 for a d orbital. The m value defines the directionality of the orbital, and the limitations on its value explain why we have one type of s orbital, three types of p orbital, five types of d orbital, and so on for higher values of l. Finally, it is found that the electron itself has a quantum number called the spin quantum number, s. Regardless what the values of n, l, and m might be, s is always either positive a half or negative a half. We often refer to these two states as spin up and spin down. All of the above are for the exact solutions to the hydrogen atom, or any one electron cation such as helium plus or lithium 2 plus. For any system with two or more electrons, an exact solution to Schrödinger's equation eludes us at this time. However, it is a very good approximation to use the orbitals obtained from the hydrogen atom as a means to describe the electronic structure of atoms.